on the show, Kent. Light up, please.
Okay.
Do they have, does she have more family or something that could come stand next to you?
I'm pretty much it.
Kyle. Anybody else here?
Nope.
No.
You guys come up here closer.
I'm not kissing you, you're all sweaty.
Yeah, so.
This is where to wipe the sweat off.
Here's the girls too.
There we go. Friends, family, there we go.
Can you go to, just go to the other side. Oh, okay. Get a shot in there.
Come up and the Carabina family, please.
Well, I'd just like to say that, Tony, we're very happy for you and we're very proud of what you've accomplished over these 6 years, we've watched seven. Okay. It goes by fast. We've seen you work very hard. And you've really stayed committed a lot more than I thought maybe you would. And I'm really happy that you've done it. I just hope that you'll continue. As you said in your goal, you want to get further advanced in karate, and if you work like you did over these past few years, I'm sure you'll succeed and reach that goal. I'd like to especially thank Master Bogdanski, Mrs. Duethorn, and all the other instructors, because without them, you wouldn't be here. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.
You know, you're like a kid to me, like a third son to me, and over the past 7 years, as I watched you meet Colin's friend, and then Kyle's your brother, and come to karate, I hear what your dad is saying to you, and I hope you do too. It brings out a part of you that I don't see anywhere else. I think it's so good for you. I watched you go through the challenges a few times, and this time is how much it helped you mature and be a person of more and more character. I just, you know, that and perseverance and what you've done over the last, you know, year, it just really impresses me. And I hope you realize how much you bring in and how much you take out of this. And it's just a really special thing to you, and I really want you to stick with it. Congratulations.
This is to certify that Tony Carabina has completed all the advanced. Mr.
Ready?
Anytime you're ready.
Fine, you got it.
You're ready.
No.
Thank you.
26 years old, rough and tumble little guy, full of energy. We thought karate might be good for him to try and focus all that of that energy. He took to it right away and loved going to class. That was around 9 years ago. Kyle always has made friends easy and karate has met many people. Sad part is he's outlasted a lot of them. And he doesn't see a lot of those people again, but he's made a lot of new friends also. We think that karate has helped shape Kyle into a strong person, both physically and mentally. Kyle loves to help teach younger kids in the school and appreciates those who look up to him. Now if we could just get him to cut his hair, right?
Yeah.
Kyle always also does very well as a home-taught student. He's receiving good grades. We're very proud of his classic achievements as well. He's really worked harder for this than anything else in his life. His dedication and persistence has gotten him to where he is now. We feel that he's becoming a very respectful and goal-oriented individual and should go far in life. We have also met many friends in karate and feel that we are part of a larger extended karate family. We also want to thank the instructors who helped to keep all our kids interested in karate. To stay with something as long as they have is a testament to the ever-changing vision the school has had by the head instructors. Thank you.
Did I say anything?
Nice job, Kyle. I'm
impressed by that. What was your thought? 30 boards?
30 boards in 30 seconds. Yeah, 30 boards in 60 seconds. But yeah, man, you really.
Two buckets of ice, please.
Yeah, I wish I could just be just like you. Congratulations, Kyle. You did really good.
Thanks. What I want to tell you is when I talk about you being a role model, I want you to understand the depth of that. That again, like Mr. Telfer without words, the kids around here request you. When you're in class with them and you're teaching, I have kids going, do I get Mr. May tonight? You know, they want you, they want to model themselves after you. So by being here and the behavior that you exemplify here and what you push through and who you are as a person, kids want to be exactly like you. And I think that is the highest compliment that anybody can receive from anybody. And I could ask any boy in here, especially boys, because you're a boy, you know. That any young boy in here that's under belt in you, they want to be just like you. That's what they want to be, is they want to look like you, act like you. So I just want you to know that to be a role model. That's and I think your hair is kind of cute. It's okay. And just so everybody knows, you might never say this, but I do love you.
It's a testimony to young men and women who start in a children's class, become teenagers, and then come on to the teen class and then adult class, because the transition is never ever easy. New classes, new people, new kids, but I have to tell you, you have a good, great legacy to follow behind, right? Talk about Master Lucia starting here at 6 years old. Talk about Stinger, people like that were little kids. That really epitomized the idea of what a black belt should be. Black belts in life, black belts in character, black belts in education. And that's you're following those footsteps. You know, and like I told some of the kids in the SWAT class the other day, I said, you're the future bug, you're the future stinger. You know, that's where you're gonna be. You're on track to just be a great adult black belt too. So keep it up and we'll see if you can make your master belt before Master Lucier did, I can't remember. This is to certify that Kyle May has completed all the advanced requirements to be awarded the rank of third degree black belt in Taekwondo in the Mike Bogdanski Martial Arts System in the United States Taekwondo. I was running out of kindling for my wood stove, so it's just right. Next up, Allison Kelly.
Quiet.
punch.
Third call. Point. This side. 2-1.
Put the kicks away. Put the kicks away.
Third call. Point this side. 2-2.
Not hit him with the side.
Huh?
Not hit him with the side.
Go!
Just wait.
Come on, guys.
Oh! Next match is up. It's a boxing match. Again, second degree black belt, Mr. Zarowski.
You should keep me up.
Substitute for the grappling, Substituting for Mrs. Duethorn tonight will be Master Lucier. This is submission style grappling. Win by choke or submission lock.
Take him out quick. I'll just say one thing, Allison. We were promised we wouldn't embarrass you. But you're growing up too fast.
Yes.
I just have a new nickname for you. This doesn't just apply to Friday. It's who you are to the core. And your sister pretty much said it really great. I'm just going to start calling you Wonder Woman from now on. But I won't buy you the cute outfit that goes with it. Just the cape. I'll get you the cape. But you are. When I think about that, when I watch how you persevere through everything, just don't make yourself too sick too many times.
I would just call it sicko. Kind of goes with your personality here teaching.
Yeah, you remind me a lot of myself in a lot of ways, and in terms of the way you take things on and the way that you set high standards and you want to reach them. I think sometimes you're too hard on yourself, and I want you to just really appreciate all that you do for yourself. And all this, and the list of things, Mr. B, read, all the things you do for others is really inspiring. And I know when you wrote that you're going to go and do those things, I know you're going to be a giver when you, I don't want say grow up, when you finish growing up, I just know you're going to be one of those people, I'm going to pick up the paper someday and there's just going to be this list of things that you're doing, and then it's not self-centered, it's for others, and it's really awesome that someone at your age can be have that world perspective that you do. It's awesome.
Ms. Kelly has also been an instructor here for several years now, and it's hard to believe that are you 17 still? Still only 17, and has the maturity and determination that you do. It's a credit to you, your family, and your personality, and you've been a really big part. We're going to miss you once you go to college. You know, we know that we only have you so long because we know that mostly all the black belt kids here are college bound. You know, it's just part of, you know, the natural evolution is to train your body, train your mind to keep going, and sometimes we're lucky and we get kids back, you know, so congratulations to you for, you know, for your achievement and for being part of it. We appreciate everything you've done for us here, Sarge. This is to certify that Allison Kelly has completed to all the advanced requirements and is hereby awarded the rank of third degree black belt.
Throwing stars at the smaller targets. I'm going to set up the balloons, and I have an assistant that's going to come out later.
In secret?
Not right now. And she is going to pick the balloons by the color for the blowgun. So, hold it.
Sir.
You're on the floor.
Mr. General, I want to make a clarifier. Breaking is the boards and not your body.
Sir? Nobody get out. Board up.
Watch your face. Turn your face.
Any fingers as you can.
Guys, turn
this way. Spin it.
That's good. Right there. Right there.
Oh, I had a perfect shot. No, I don't.
Put a lot of pressure on those boards.
Chris!
Hey! Chris!
The little green balloon.
The big.
This little green.
Yeah! Grizz. Nope, you're.
Back up some more, please.
I don't want the darts falling down.
Take it on.
This one first.
The
dark green one. This one?
Family, come up, please. Yeah, shoot one more.
Next challenge.
I like covered, Mom.
That was cool, Riz.
I can breathe again. How do you spell, really? It's over!
We're going out.
Determination has paid off. I think he sets a good example for both of his children and the rest of the family that he has here, because he certainly feels that this is his family as well as all of those sitting out there. Just keep up the good work, and now can we ease off a bit?
Now he wants one of these, though. Yeah.
This is the first time he's a higher rank than me.
I think what Mrs. Drendron hit on is really important. She talked about it being a family. I think we're a great family school by the number of adults and kids we have here. I think we're even better as a family up here and how we support each other. And I know, Grizz, you've supported me a lot. I hope, you know, we have a relationship that's gone back and forth like that. Until coming to a place like this, you know, the word family meant to me someone related blood to you. But it's in moments that we've shared here that it becomes something much deeper and much actually more special. And I know I consider you part of my family. And I guess the role I would have to say is brother. Because one night, Grizz and I were fighting in the back of the dojo, which we sometimes do, and Mr. B was yelling at us about fighting. And then, of course, I had to walk back with him up here and with Mr. B, and he was saying, you know, you shouldn't be doing that, you guys shouldn't be doing that. And my initial reaction was to say out loud, but he started it. Okay. And I thought, the last time I had said that was when I was a kid, probably with my sister. So that I just, you know, I consider you part of my family. You have a very special place in my heart. And if I were to pick out one thing that you did tonight, the sword form, I think for all of us, you've set the tone with that. You know, I want my sword form to look like yours. Just looking at what you've done with that. And then, the time it took and the way you did this time, I think, I know, you have a lot to be proud of, and everybody here, I think, connects to what you did. So congratulations. I just want you to know what an inspiration you are to me. Not just because you're older, but but what you inspire, and you are truly a giver. You have a hard time taking from people, which you're learning here, and you've done a great job with that too, but you are truly a giver. When I watch you in class, if you were to walk in, not in your karate uniform, you're not supposed to be teaching, you almost can't contain yourself. When you see somebody struggling, you just want to help them. And I think that's a great quality to have, because people recognize that in you. And when I see students out here turn to you for that kind of stuff, they know it's a solid thing. Like, people need a foundation. And I guess what I'm saying, you're solid in their lives. It's something they can count on. They know they can always go to Grizz for certain things. So, and I know that about myself now. It doesn't matter what rank I am. I watch how you do things, and I'm thinking, I want to do it like that. So I want to know, in many ways, I see you as my teacher because of how you are and how much you put into people, and how much I really appreciate you.
I'd like to say thank you, the whole family. They had to put up with a lot. I'd like to say thank you to all friends and family that came tonight, and all the black belts. There's a lot of black belts we haven't seen in a while. I'm glad you all showed up. And thank you to all the instructors that put up with me.
So if you're Mrs. Duthorn's brother, then some days I am your father.
Does that mean he's supposed to call you Grampy?
And so what we make sure we do, too, is to try to make sure that Grizz is not hurting himself in any way, because he always gives 110% on a regular basis, and most days 200%. So sometimes we tease you.